Well, one of the only times I'll say this, time to kick ass and take names, WWE Stomping Grounds 2019 pay-per-view review / results is next. Also, what's next? Bro, that damn intro. Okay, what's going on, guys? Yes, Fortminded Project back at it again in here for this video for you guys for today. And in here for my WWE Stomping Grounds 2019 pay-per-view review / results. Be sure to leave a like if you like the video, and as well, be sure to comment, and as well, subscribe and hit the notification bell for up-to-date on my latest videos. So without further ado, let's get right down into it, and then I will talk about how I felt about WWE Stomping Grounds 2019. And we had the kickoff, we had a vintage triple threat match for the Cruiserweight Championship, where we had Drew Gulak, Akira Tozawa, and as well with Tony Nese. And this is one of those matches that's basically too good for the kickoff that should be on the main card, but it wasn't, and it was actually a good match. I've been liking what 205 Live has been doing as of late, and I feel like, too, they're kind of in the way underrated and everything, and hopefully in the fall, 205 Live can actually be before SmackDown. I think that would be a lot more better, since after SmackDown, people are basically tired and kind of want to leave and stuff like that. So I feel like that's, in a way, what's also been hurting them, with people leaving and stuff after SmackDown. So with this one, we did have Drew Gulak actually winning the Cruiserweight Championship. It doesn't really surprise me. I think that's cool. He's been having a little bit of a change lately and everything. And, you know, they've been having to see who would be the number one contender to face Tony Nese before this. And that's why they had a triple threat match and everything. So, I want to see what Drew Gulak does and everything. So, now it's probably, I think, to him, is his Drewtopia and everything. And it feels like a better 205 life for him. And I wonder where things are going to go now that he's going to be Cruiserweight Champion. Probably going to showboat and stuff like that. And, should be interesting. So, yeah, pretty happy for Drew Gulak, so that's cool. Long time coming, too. Next one, when we got the main card, the Raw Women's Championship on the line between Becky Lynch and Lacey Evans. And hopefully, this feud will be basically done and over with. And Becky Lynch, obviously, was able to retain. That's a good thing to keep things going. And maybe we'll have some new feuds, some new challengers going for Becky Lynch. I think it's definitely needed at this point. We kind of had like a little tease by Paul Heyman to see if Brock Lesnar was going to cash in and stuff like that. We didn't really get to see that, which is good, but I'm kind of nervous when that's going to happen. It could happen at any point. Might happen at SummerSlam or before then. It could happen at Extreme Rules, which is coming up next month. So basically, it'll be here before you know it. But the next match, where we had the tag team match with Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn taking on The New Day, Xavier Woods, and Big E on this one. This one was actually an enjoyable tag team match, and Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn getting the win. This is, you know, one of those things where I wish they were both on the same brand, but technically they kind of are, with the whole, you know, new rule that they got and everything with the wild card. It's just really weird. Life doesn't have to make sense, I guess, like I mentioned on Twitter and stuff. So, you know, at this point, I wouldn't mind seeing them going after the tag team titles, but it would be kind of weird because they're on separate brands. Sami Zayn on Raw, Kevin Owens on SmackDown, and winning one of the Raw or SmackDown tag team titles. I don't know how that's going to go, but that remains to be seen. Next match, probably one of my favorite matches on the night that I was looking forward to. The United States Championship match. I'm happy I got some time on this one between Ricochet and Samoa Joe. And Samoa Joe and his matches lately haven't been really far too long, but this one, you know, was worth it. We had Ricochet winning the United States Championship. That was cool. I hope that lasts. That's dope. And congrats to Ricochet on that. I want to see what's up with that, and maybe feud with Samoa Joe for a while, and that maybe have Rey Mysterio into the mix. So that would be pretty cool to see. So there was that. So happy for Ricochet there. Next, we had the SmackDown Tag Team Championship match. Daniel Bryan and Roman, the Planet's Tag Team Champions, taking on Heavy Machinery. And, you know, this one wasn't too bad, you know, almost, you know, kind of like a TV match in a way, if you want to put it that way, but, you know, pretty enjoyable. Obviously, Daniel Bryan and Rowan were able to get the win. Heavy Machinery came close in this one, so we'll see who else is going to be the next tag team to face the Planet's Tag Team Champions, and Daniel Bryan and Rowan, since I actually like them as tag team champions, so can't go wrong with that. Next match, SmackDown Women's Championship, where we had Nikki Cross at ringside, Bayley, and as well Alexa Bliss. And this one was honestly a lot more better than when they were last feuding. I will say that. And of course, Alexa Bliss messing with Nikki Cross, trying to get her on his side, much like how she did with Mickie James and everything. You know, that whole thing, you know, just trying to mess with people, trying to get in their heads and stuff like that, and pretending to be their friend. And in the end, that's what was able to help Bayley get the win and retain, which was the right move, and to keep Bayley as SmackDown Women's Champion. So hopefully that feud is basically done. And I would like to see Nikki Cross and as well Alexa Bliss at least try and work things out, be in the tag team division for the women's side, because, you know, they haven't really been doing a whole lot with the Women's Tag Team Championships, and that's really upsetting. So hopefully, you know, they'll be able to do some more things there as a team. Next, well, we have Roman Reigns and Drew McIntyre. Didn't really care for this one. Again, hopefully this feud is basically done and over with, and Roman Reigns gets the win. And Shane McMahon was able to try and help out Drew McIntyre so much out of desperation, just didn't do it, wasn't working. And, of course, Roman Reigns was able to come back and get the win. So, you know, I guess can't really complain, even though I would like to see more out of Drew McIntyre and everything. Hopefully be in the main event, which he should be at this point, going after the Raw Universal Championship. I think that would make sense, so that remains to be seen. Then we had the Steel Cage match, WWE Championship match, between Kofi Kingston and as well Dolph Ziggler. No members of the New Day were out there. It was just them two going at it. It was interesting how literally a leap of faith, Kofi Kingston actually leaping out through the door and actually getting the win there and retaining the championship. New Day was out there and everything, so I had that celebration. And Kofi Kingston is still champion, and I know for the most part, I know they've been pushing Shane McMahon and stuff and possibly being WWE champion, which honestly, in my honest opinion, I feel like that wouldn't be so bad as having Shane McMahon being WWE champion and beating Kofi Kingston. It'd actually be a lot more better than Brock Lesnar actually beating Kofi Kingston, and especially being a double champion. So I don't know, we'll see where that goes, but who knows, maybe Kofi Kingston can win over Shane McMahon too and everything, so never really know. But that's for another time, and maybe who knows when that will happen. Maybe Extreme Rules or SummerSlam, remains to be seen. Then the main event, of course, Universal Championship match, Seth Rollins and Baron Corbin. Special guest referee, it could have been anybody, could have been Eric Young, it could have been EC3, but it was a little underwhelming seeing Lacey Evans as the special guest referee and everything, you know, taking it to her advantage and messing around with Seth Rollins, and unfortunately, you know, with him getting, like, pissed off and having the steel chair shots he's been using lately, and taking out Baron Corbin. We had a table spot, that was cool. And then after a while, we had Becky Lynch coming out, having enough, after where Lacey Evans hitting Seth Rollins right in the balls and everything, basically. And then, you know, giving it to Lacey Evans, and then Seth Rollins was able to capitalize, get the win, retain the Raw Universal Championship, and basically calling it a day. And that's it for WWE Stomping Grounds. So, what did I think of it? What is my honest opinion? You know, pretty good. It wasn't the greatest or anything like that, but there was only those two matches that I didn't really care for too much on there. So, you know, that's fine, I guess. But, you know, hopefully now with AEW around and Fighter Fest really being, like, I believe this weekend, this Saturday, so I might try and do your predictions for that. If not, probably just a review on it, since I'm still trying to get used to some of the people there. I know some of them, like, of course, Chris Jericho, Ty Dillinger, and Ali, and a few other people that I have been familiar with Impact Wrestling or Lucha Underground or Ring of Honor and stuff like that. So I've been watching, of course, other companies too as well to, you know, get introduced to them and stuff like that to see who will be possibly be in the AEW, but I'll save it for them. So that should be interesting. That's actually free on Bleacher Report Live, so that should be interesting there on top of that. But pretty good for WWE Stomping Grounds. Those are my thoughts and opinions. What are your own thoughts and opinions? How did you feel about WWE Stomping Grounds? And who knows if it'll be back. It'll probably be like a Great Balls of Fire. And it'll be like a one-time thing, since I know their schedule for pay-per-views has been kind of out of whack lately. And so that's about it for this video, this review slash results. Until then, leave a like, leave a comment. Of course, as always, subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date on the latest videos. Until then, I catch you guys in the next video, whenever the hell that next video may be. Until then, I'll catch you then. See ya. Peace.